morning, everyone. Actually, it's good afternoon. It's just 1 minute past 12. Hello, I'm Fred Lugo. Welcome back. I see a number of new faces as well. We're so delighted that you're here for this very, very special event. This marks our 47th year of service in Travis County. Since 1972, we've been serving you and you've been serving the people here in this community. To celebrate, we went with a 50s theme. Many of you lived during the 50s. Baby boomers look back nostalgically to these years. It marked their early childhood experience. It marked a time when things were changing in this country and the notion of happy days lived. So we call this year's theme Sock Hop to reflect happy days that some of us remember from that time. We had a few coming-of-age staff dress in 50s style getup as well as volunteers. So why don't all of you stand up so we can see your getups? Staff and volunteers who dressed up in 50s style. I see. That's right. We have some poodle skirts out there. Rosie the Riveter I see out there. There she is. Thank you all for getting into the mood. And let me introduce the members of my staff. Please stand as I call your name. Don Diekman, our Community Engagement Coordinator. There's Don. Monica Flores Rojo, our Administrative Assistant. Deborah Price, our Community Engagement Coordinator. Katie Reeves, our Communications Coordinator. LaDonna Woodley, our Training and Education Coordinator. And myself. And you can't see behind this podium, I'm actually wearing blue suede shoes. You can see them later. If you got here in time, you were able to enjoy the pre-event reception taking place across the hall. Hors d'oeuvres, giveaways, socializing, and finding out about the work of this year's invited vendors. Vendors, thank you for being here. They are Joshua's Stage, Creative Action, Communities and Schools, We Are Blood, Community Tech Network, Hospice Austin, and WellCare. Vendors, thank you so much. Now I'd like to introduce our incredible Board of Directors and Advisory Council. They're your hosts and assist to accomplish our mission. Let me introduce them. Their names are on the screen here to your right and left. Please stand as I call your name. Alice Latino, President. Penny Seidel, Vice President. Richard Bondi, Treasurer. Jody Gray, Secretary. And Christina Williams. Those are members of our board. From our advisory council, we have Suzanne Anderson, Lisa Barden, Soccer Chapman Thomas, Nola Marie Dilworth, Scott Ella, Cindy Gunderson, Dr. Karen Hayward, George Lineal, Anna Madrigal, Betty Ann Simmons, Jim Spencer, Celeste Villarreal, Mary Voorhees, and Kara Whitney. Thank you, Board and Advisory Council, for your support. As you know, coming of age is part of Travis County. So I'd like to recognize those representing Travis County and our Health and Human Services Department. Ross Stevens, Community Services Division Director for Travis County Health and Human Services. Representing Travis County Commissioner Margaret Gomez, Carly Arnold, David Salazar, and Norma Guetta. Representing Travis County Commissioner Bridget Shea, Lanny Oglewood, and Barbara Rush. And representing County Commissioner Jeff Trevelyan, Caitlin Brown, and Dion White. Is Commissioner Trevelyan here? I'm trying to look for him. Is he here? Okay, not here. Thank you. So, our Community Services Division Director, Ross Stevens, would like to say a few words.
Thank you. Good afternoon. Thank you so much for the opportunity. I bring greetings from my executive management team and all of Travis County Health and Human Services. I'm truly humbled to be here today and work for an agency that inspires me and who's helped shape my thinking with regards to volunteers. I'm truly blessed and thank you for this opportunity. My intent is not to keep you too long today, so I will leave you with a quote. The great Muhammad Ali says, "Service to others is the rent paid for your room on this earth." So as for today, everybody's rent is paid. Thank you.
Thank you, Ross. I also want to acknowledge the support that we received from Texas Health and Human Services for our SDP program. Today we have Claire Irwin, the Age Well, Live Well coordinator at Texas Health and Human Services. We also have a couple of board commissioners from the City of Austin. They are Charles Curry from the LGBT Quality of Life Commission and Karen Grant from the Commission on Seniors. Thank you for being here. We're also delighted to have the Executive Director of Austin Up, Teresa Ferguson. Saw her somewhere. There you are. Glad you're here as well. The RSVP program began here in Travis County 47 years ago. That was made possible through a grant that we received back then from the Federal Agency Action. Today it's called the Corporation for National and Community Service, and we still get that federal grant. Today, we're honored to have a huge supporter of our SVP, Senior Corps, and those who volunteer their time to help improve communities locally in Texas and across America. United States Congressman Lloyd Doggett.
You know, there was a time a little while ago when I served this area as state senator, and I met many of you then. Back then, I covered Johnson City also. It was so small that when we had the rodeo county fair every summer, they went around the town square twice, and you got to wave a second time, and everybody was always friendly. Well, back then, I'd get a call from a seniors group, and they'd say they wanted a young, dynamic speaker. Now, for some reason, I get these calls about maturity and somebody about our age. I am pleased to be with you, as I have been on a number of occasions earlier in the life of this organization, and it is truly inspiring to look out on a group that I know has had a hand literally in shaping and molding this community to be the great place that it is today, that is drawing people from all over the world to Austin. I know that many of you have been here for decades, and a few of you got here as quickly as your grandchildren called. But however long you've been here, this special place is better because of your presence. I look back in my records, and I first spoke to this organization just after I was elected to Congress in 1995. Back then, it was called RSVP, but I think the spirit of volunteerism that existed then is very much present today with a new name. And yes, whenever the call for help comes, the RSVP from you as volunteers has been, yes, I'll be there. No matter what the name of the organization, one thing is clear, you have a long and distinguished history of contributing in this community and just to bringing joy to the lives of some of the people that you touch or transport or work with or respond to. I particularly want to salute Fred. He's been an able advocate for this organization when he's come to Washington and an able administrator along with the team that he's built to see that your volunteer efforts go the furthest to where they're needed the most. So let's give him another round of applause. I know you've had many varied activities, but it was great to meet your honorees. They'll be presented in greater detail in a few minutes, but knowing that Estrelita has played a big role with English as a second language at Foundation Communities, an organization that does so much good in our community, and that Nola Marie has worked with Family Elder Care, another excellent organization. I congratulate and salute both of you. In Washington, I continue to work as chairman of the Health Subcommittee to provide support and improvement in programs created by FDR and LBJ, both Social Security and Medicare, that are so very important to us, particularly looking for a solution to the problem of the soaring cost of prescription drugs that afflict so many people and force people to cut pills when what we need to do is cut prices. And as Fred mentioned, very important to this organization has been support for AmeriCorps and the Senior Corps and the Corporation for National Community Service. In my separate work on the Budget Committee, I've worked to ensure that those organizations get the dollars that they need and to resist those who would terminate them. There's a saying that I'm sure you're familiar with, but it has particular meaning here today, and that is that the only true gift is the gift of thyself. You have given of yourself to make this a better community. I appreciate the opportunity to represent many of you in Washington, and always look forward to your advice and to your calls when we can be of assistance. Have a great gathering.
Thank you, Congressman. I'd now like to ask Penny Seidel, our Board Vice President, to come to the podium.
Thank you, Fred. As Fred said, I'm Penny Seidel, and I'd like to welcome all of you to this wonderful event. On behalf of the Board and Advisory Council, I want to say thank you so much for your volunteer service. All year long, you've done so much, so well, so superbly. It's an honor to be able to host this event and to be part of this special recognition. This event is made possible with the support of some incredible sponsors and donors. This year, they include, and our platinum sponsor is WellCare. We want to thank WellCare, a newcomer to our community, for their commitment to the purpose and mission of coming of age in RSVP, and for the great t-shirts that you all should have received. Ta-da! I'd like to ask Les Herrera from WellCare to come up and say a few words. I just got a secret. You are the former RSVP director from San Antonio.
Right.
Welcome home now.
Thank you, everyone. It's good to know that WellCare is growing strong and can continue to succeed. Thanks to y'all's time and effort that you give to the nonprofit organizations that you serve. Want to thank Fred, and Coming of Age for allowing us the opportunity to be here. Pretty much that's it. Thank you so much for your volunteer efforts.
A great big hand for all that you've done. Thank you, thank you, thank you. The second is our gold sponsor, and our gold sponsor is the Helen S. and John J. McKenna Jr. Charitable Foundation. And I'm going to give you a little bit of history here. For the past 25 years, Dr. John McKenna was a huge believer in the work of RSVP, now known as Coming of Age, and was the former dean of the School of Chemical Engineering at UT. He was also a former member of our own advisory council. Earlier this year, he passed away at the age of 103. Is that amazing? His family foundation continues to support us and his passion, volunteerism. He wrote about the habits, or energy lessons, I like to call them, that served him well throughout his 103 years. I'd like to share some of those with you. So if you just kind of sit back and let your ears do the thinking for you. Being approachable, Laugh at yourself. Appreciate your parents. Give back. Say yes. Be accountable. Pay it forward. And we all know what that's important. Celebrate your friends. Face your mortality. Be optimistic. Embrace odd jobs. And that's something that's kind of neat whenever, you know, somebody comes in and says, would you like to help do this? And you say, of course, I would. And you think, I've never done that in my life, but I'll learn. Give hugs. And everybody knows me. I'm a hugger, so this is right up my alley. Be vulnerable. Step out of your comfort zone. Recognize that everyone is special. And never grow up completely. That's something we all have to work on. Host generously. Evolve or perish. Change is a constant in life. And give what gives you energy and do it each day. And I think that's probably the strongest and the best. Thank you, Dr. Maketa and family. And now our silver sponsors. Shown on the slide, they are Dr. and Mrs. Tom Seidel, Jody Gray and family, Mary Voorhees and the Southwick family, and Texas Oncology. Let's give our silver sponsors a hand. This year's bronze sponsors include Sakar Chapman Thomas, Cindy Gunderson, Halicon Home Health and Hospice, Heavenly Care Home Health, KXAN and Jim Spencer, the LGBT Elder Task Force, and Mud Puppies. Please join me in a round of applause for them. I hope you also noticed the ads in the program that's at your tables for our platinum, gold, silver, and bronze sponsors. So take a moment and look at those later when you have a few seconds. Our donors provided many door prizes for this year's event. We've already given away 10 prizes out in the pre-function event across the hall, and we have 20 more to give away. We'll get to that shortly. But now I'd like to recognize our donors that made these gift cards possible. Richard Bondi, Sakar Chapman Thomas, Nola Marie Dilworth, Graham Duncan, Jody Gray, Cindy Gunderson, Karen Hayward, Alice Latino, George Linnell, Francisca Lugo, Fred Lugo, Sam and Deborah Price, Jim Spencer, Mary Voorhees, and Christina Williams. Thank you, donors. Throughout this year, I've had an opportunity at our board meetings and our advisory council meetings to hear a lot about the incredible work that you all do. And your story of service was all about strengthening our community, helping nonprofit organizations and agencies achieve their missions. And that's huge because out there we're serving others. Some important facts you should be proud of include that you were a part of 424 coming of age and RSVP volunteers that provided, now get this, 77,439 hours of service at seven. At 71 nonprofit, faith-based, and public agencies in Travis County. Some of the areas that you served in included disaster services, independent living, education, hunger, veteran services, fundraising for nonprofits, health services, and by recruiting and managing volunteers for nonprofits. The impact of your volunteer service translated to an added value of, and this is amazing, Fred, I'm really, $746,647 for Travis County taxpayers. That's a huge. Travis County's investment in coming of age produced fourfold returns. That is amazing. Thank you, thank you, thank you, everyone. But that's just a very small part of this year's highlights. You can read more about what we've accomplished, what you accomplished this past year on page 8 of your program. Fred, staff, and volunteers, on behalf of the Board and Advisory Council, thank you for your incredible job and accomplishments this past year.
Thank you, Penny. Oh, don't leave, don't leave. So what can I tell you as we look ahead? The Austin metropolitan area has the fastest growing older adult population and second fastest growing senior population. Let me say this right. The Austin metropolitan area has the fastest growing pre-senior population in the country and the second fastest. I'm still gonna get it wrong, aren't I, Teresa? I look at Teresa because she can spout these stats right off the top of her head. The second fastest growing senior population and the second fastest growing, I still got it wrong. Anyway, it's really way up there, whatever it is. We know the needs in our community. We'll keep on growing. That we do know. We're continually striving to provide new and innovative ways to inspire and enable you to affect change in our community. So stay tuned. Now in his 29th year at KXAN, Emmy Award-winning weathercaster Jim Spencer has been forecasting Austin and Central Texas weather longer than anyone in the history of Austin television. He has received national recognition for his work. He is a past recipient of the National Weather Association's Weathercaster of the Year Award. Jim has been awarded 3 Emmys for his work and has been nominated for several more. He is also a 5-time winner of the Texas Associated Press Best Weathercast Award. He's been voted Austin's best weathercaster 20 times by readers of the Austin Chronicle and was named best weather reporter in the Austin American Statesman's Best of the Best Awards in 2018. Ladies and gentlemen, our MC, Jim Spencer.
Well, after that long introduction, that's all the time we have, ladies and gentlemen. Have a great day. Thank you, Fred, for those very kind words, and thank you all for having me back here today. I think it could have something to do with the fact that every year when we have this luncheon, the weather is perfect, right? You're welcome. It is a real privilege for me to be back here again this year to talk to you all about something besides the weather. I love talking about the weather. Yes, it's going to be partly cloudy today and about 92 degrees. That way you don't have to watch. No, you need to watch tonight. Never mind that I said that. Weekend, though, it's going to get close to 100 this weekend. Heat index about 105 to 110. So stay in the air conditioning this weekend if you possibly can. And just as a quick aside, Nola Marie's here too. You're going to hear about her. She works with Family Elder Care. But we at KXAN are one of the partners with Family Elder Care in our summer fan drive. Many of you are familiar with that. And so, thank you. I think we've been doing that for more than 25 years. And it really is a life-saving project because there are seniors in our community that don't run their air conditioners in the summer if they have one sometimes because their electricity bill is too high, or sometimes they have broken air conditioners. And so when you see us talking about our fans from Fans Day next Friday at Shady Grove Cafe, or just throughout the summer when we talk about the summer fan drive, if you can donate a simple box fan, that can save someone's life literally in our community. And you know how hot these summers have been getting, hotter and hotter. So we would really appreciate your support of that. Thank you, Fred, for letting me give a little plug to our summer fan drive at the KXAN. It's important. It really, really is. Before we get started with the awards, I'd like to say just a couple of words here. We are gathered here today, obviously, to acknowledge you, and this is one of the most fun luncheons that I have the opportunity to MC every year. I love to MC this luncheon because it is all about giving awards to people who make a difference in our community, and there's nothing neater to be able to hand out awards to people, right? I did the Maudie's Margarita run last night, MC'd that, so I'm moving a little slowly today. But of all the things I MC, this is number one right here. It's about honoring you all, and I'm just amazed each and every year about the words that I read about what you do, and I'm gonna get to those in just a minute. But before we get started, I'd like to take just a moment to express our thanks to our director, Fred Lugo. Now, he does not know that I'm about to say this, but as you all know, Fred has been presiding over this annual recognition luncheon and presenting the awards to our volunteers every year without any recognition himself. And so we decide, and I say we, Graham Duncan, who I've served on our advisory board with for quite some time, we were gonna honor Graham some today, and he said, you know what, you guys honor me at our next meeting, okay? I think it's time, beyond time, that we honor Fred. So, Graham, if you wouldn't mind coming up here, this was your idea, and we all said, absolutely, this is way past due. This is Graham Duncan, and Graham's gonna hand out the award, but let me tell you just real quickly a little about more about Fred. He's been in public service with Travis County for 30 years, 25 of them as director of the RSVP and Coming of Age program. During this long period of service, Fred has demonstrated that he is a visionary. You all don't see the things that go on 365 days a year behind the scenes to keep this program alive and vital and forward-looking, but Fred is the driving force behind all of that. He has demonstrated with that vision that the organization keeps up to date with trends of care of older adults for whom he has always shown the utmost compassion. In the last few years, he's led the charge in recognizing that the volunteer style of younger retirees was changing from that of the older generation. And so he explored and found a new approach to attract this younger generation to volunteerism, which led to the establishment of Coming of Age alongside our RSVP program. By the use of this innovation, he has allowed Coming of Age to stay on the cutting edge. And so the board and the advisory council of Coming of Age would now like to recognize his outstanding service by presenting him with this plaque. And Graham, would you like to tell us what's on that plaque?
Yes, it says, from the Coming of Age Council and Board, in recognition of your continuing dedication and commitment to improving Travis County community by the promotion of volunteering, which could not have been achieved without your inspirational leadership over many years.
Wasn't expecting this. This is about, today's event is about you, about the service that you provide. But it has been my honor to be able to serve each and every one of you every day of the year. What you do is so inspirational. Every one of you is involved in something that makes a difference in the life of an individual, in the life of our community. And that's what inspires me to continue to work for Coming of Age and our SVP. Thank you all so very much.
Thank you, Fred, and congratulations again. It's such a privilege to work alongside you. Can I borrow those blue suede shoes? Are they size 9, 10-ish? Perfect. All right, we're going to begin with our volunteer awards portion of this program by recognizing those who've been making a difference in our community for 15 years through RSVP and Coming of Age. And we have 9 volunteers that are being recognized for 15 years of service. So would the following please come up to the stage? Joan Cox, Fran Lugo, Bernie O'Neill, Trudy O'Neill, Bertha Sellers Price, Margaret Slayton, Aina Toivonen. Would you all come up here, please? As they do, let me tell you some about our 15-year service award winners today. Joan Cox serves at South Austin Senior Activity Center, also the City of Austin Watershed Program, the HAM Radio, and CERT, the Community Emergency Response Team. She's very busy. Fran Lugo, Fred's mom, by the way. I wonder if that has anything to do with her forced volunteer work. No, she would be out there anyway. But Fran assists with special projects at Coming of Age, of course, and she has been an active volunteer at Zilker and Sanchez Elementary Schools and at St. David's South Hospital. Bernie and Trudy O'Neill volunteered at the CARE Communities as part of a CARE team. By the way, Bernie and Trudy O'Neill, Katie Reeves from our staff right there, her parents. You're not forced into this too, are you? Bernie and Trudy volunteered at the CARE Communities as part of a CARE team before they closed their doors last year. Bernie also volunteered for Mobile Loaves and Fishes, and Trudy worked with Baby Bundles. Currently, they provide transportation to ensure seniors can remain living independently in their homes, and Bernie volunteers with his church and food bank. Bertha Sellers Price volunteers at the Conley Guerrero Senior Activity Center Meals on Wheels program. Margaret Slayton volunteers in the Seton Northwest Gift Shop. And Aina Toivonen volunteers with the Senior Access Program. To all 7 of you, we thank you for 15 years of outstanding service to our community. If you'd stay right here and look at our event photographer straight ahead. Everybody look at the event photographer straight ahead. Okay, thank you all. Now, let's go to our recognition of those who have served for 20 years. Ronald Friedman and Richard LaFleur, would you come up? Also, Mary Bolden and Martha Lohr. These are 20 and 25 years of service members. Mary Bolden and Martha Lohr, we're honoring them today for 25 years of service. And Ronald Friedman and Richard LaFleur, if you're here for 20 years of service, we'd like to recognize you. Come right up. Martha, right there she is. I see in my script that Ronald and Richard could not be here today, but let me tell you anyway what they have done. Ronald currently volunteers with the Dell Children's Hospital, and Richard manages the Meals on Wheels program operated through the Manchac Methodist Church. Our 25-year award recipients are Mary Bolden and Martha Lohr. And Martha is right here. Mary can't be here today. She's an active volunteer with Meals on Wheels and at the Old Bakery and Emporium. And she's probably delivering meals at this very moment. Let me tell you about Martha. Martha is a dedicated volunteer who volunteers at many places. including Drive a Senior program, where she's held almost every position that you can have there. We Are Blood, IACT, Faith Food Pantries, Faith Presbyterian Church, and more. Martha has reported 5,563 volunteer hours to us. She was recognized in 2011 with our Spirit of Service Award for the work she's done with Drive a Senior South Austin. So please join me in a round of applause to thank the three who are unable to be here and Martha right here for 25 years of service. We are so glad to have you as part of Coming of Age and RSVP. And today happens to be her 67th wedding anniversary. Congratulations, Martha. Let's go next to our volunteers who have achieved 1,000 and 2,000 hours of service just in this past year. There are 12 volunteers that have served more than 1,000 hours of service in this past year. Let me have you all 12 of you, come to the stage, please. Andy Anthony, Gay Crocker, Nola Marie Dilworth, Suzanne Fought, Hal Ferguson, Penny Gehring, Alan Huddleston, Patricia Lovett, Bill Miller, Don Sagert, Pamela Spann, and Michael Wadino. Would you all please come forward? As they come forward, let me tell you what they have done in this past year, these many, many hours of service. Andy Anthony volunteered 1,682 hours with Texas Search and Rescue, also known as TechSAR. Gay Crocker volunteered 1,915 hours with TechSAR and the Williamson County Animal Shelter. And she is a clinical research associate by trade and enjoys working within the TechSAR Canine Division, in addition to doing deployments with them. Nola Marie Dilworth, my fellow advisory council member, Nola Marie right here, also family elder care, I see her there. She volunteered 1,422 hours with Family Elder Care, Dell Children's Hospital, Coming of Age, and Hospice Austin just in the last year. Suzanne Fought volunteered 1,056 hours with South Austin Hospital, Central Texas Veterans Healthcare System, and the Austin Disaster Relief Ministry. Hal Ferguson served 1,282 hours at South Austin Hospital. Penny Gehring volunteered 1,718 hours with TechSAR. Penny was recognized by the City of Austin in 2017. She's a coming of age, that is, in 2017. She spearheads the behind-the-scenes requirements of TechSAR deployments and assists with promotion of the organization, as well as other volunteer management duties. Alan Huddleston served 1,580 hours with TechSAR. Patricia Lovett volunteered 1,026 hours with Seton Northwest. Bill Miller volunteered 1,081 hours with Drive a Senior West. Don Sagert served 1,278 hours with Drive a Senior North Central. Pamela Spann volunteered 1,569 hours with TechSAR. And Michael Wadino volunteered 1,920 hours with the American Red Cross. Did you know that 1,000 hours of service a year is about 20 hours a week? That is dedication. Thank you all. Seven volunteers today are being recognized for serving more than 2,000 hours in this past year. Let's have Marjorie Beeman, Althea Conrado, Brandon Gehring, Del Goss, Sean Honestreeter, Bertha Sellers-Price, and Nancy Walker all please come forward to the stage. I know there are a couple of those not here today. And I'm going to tell you about all of these Super Seven, we'll call them today. This year we recognize again Margarine Beeman for serving over 2,000 hours. It seems like, I don't know how many of these I have been to every year where Margarine Beeman is awarded for serving thousands of hours or for some other reason. She is amazing. I call her an Energizer Bunny. In fact, I talked to her before the luncheon. She said she's already put in 7 hours today before the luncheon. Over the last year, she volunteered 3,884 hours. Some of the places she makes a difference, and these are just some. AISD, American Youth Works, Austin Council for the Blind, the Bob Bullock Museum, Operation Blue Santa, the Conley Guerrero Senior Activities Center, numerous public safety programs, the Lady Bird Johnson Wildflower Center, Meals on Wheels, and the LBJ Museum. Margarine, thank you. Althea Conrado. She volunteered 3,961 hours knitting lap blankets for the patients at the AMED Community Hospice of the North Area. Althea has donated 21,320 hours knitting blankets since joining Coming of Age 11 years ago. Brandon Gehring served 3,525 hours at Texas Search and Rescue. He's one of the founding members of TechSAR and has been instrumental in developing their technological capabilities, including their volunteer management database. Brandon serves as the vice chairman on their board of directors. Del Goss was our 2018 Spirit of Service Award winner. This past year, Del reports serving more than 2,067 hours. He helps in many different ways, but consistently donates his time to the Austin Humane Society, Emancipet, Florence's Comfort House, the Montopolis Community Alliance, the Austin Animal Center, and the City of Austin's Electric Board. Sean Hahnstrider volunteered 3,281 hours in 2018. His passion for assisting with disaster response stemmed from spending 18 months helping to rebuild homes destroyed by Hurricane Katrina, while also volunteering with Fairhaven Children's Home in Louisiana. Sean serves as board chairman and operations chief of TechSAR and has served on the Rodeo Austin board for over a decade, currently serving as a board member and chairman of operations. Bertha Sellers Price reported 2,492 volunteer hours to us last year. She is an active participant at the Conley Guerrero Senior Activity Center Meals on Wheels program and assists at many other agencies in Austin. Nancy Walker has been the volunteer executive director for the Funeral Consumers Alliance of Central Texas since 2015. She coordinates and facilitates end-of-life options classes, conducts in-service training for hospices and other healthcare providers, produces the FCA CTX quarterly newsletter and annual funeral home price survey. She maintains membership records, oversees office operations and volunteers, and serves on various community councils and more. Nancy reported 2,578 volunteer hours last year. When someone volunteers more than 2,000 hours in 1 year, you know that their service is also their passion, their inspiration to us all. You all are an inspiration to us all. A round of applause. Thank you for your service. This year, we add Andy Anthony, you all please come to the front, Andy Anthony, Gay Crocker, Luis Fernandez, Penny Gehring, and Gladys Hill to the growing list of volunteers receiving the President's Gold Service Award. As they make their way up here to the front, let me tell you a little about this award. The President's Council on Service and Civic Participation recognizes the valuable contributions that volunteers are making in our communities and encourages more people to serve. The President's Gold Service Award is given to thank and honor Americans who, by their demonstrated commitment and example, inspire others to engage in volunteer service. The award recognizes United States citizens who have achieved over 4,000 hours or more of volunteer service during their lifetime. Now, Andy Anthony can't be here today, but in just over 6 years, he's reported 5,474 hours of service. In less than 3 years, Gay Crocker has reported 4,475 hours of service. She volunteers with Texar and the Williamson County Animal Shelter. Luis Fernandez has been with Coming of Age for almost 14 years and reported 4,225 hours. She volunteers at many locations, including the Austin Symphony, the Central Texas Veterans Healthcare System, and Learning Ally. In 4 years, Penny Gehring has reported 4,570 hours of service, all but 8 hours of that with Texas Search and Rescue. The other 8 hours were with a coming-of-age disaster preparedness project. Gladys Hill wasn't able to be with us today, but she's been with Coming of Age for 19 and a half years. She's reported 4,217 hours. She volunteers at the Lamar Senior Activity Center and has served in various volunteer roles there. To all of you, we thank you for your service.
Stay right here if you would. We want to get one official group photo. Look right down the middle there. Thank you.
And now, the highlight of today's event, the 2019 Spirit of Service Awards. The Spirit of Service Awards were created to acknowledge the success and achievement of a very limited number of volunteers for exceptional contributions to the community. Our Spirit of Service Award recipients receive rewards from volunteering that are deeply personal to them and spring from their desire to help those in need. Nola Marie Dilworth, would you please join us up on stage? Nola, as she comes up, I'll tell you a little about her. She joined our program, Coming of Age, and I have the privilege of serving with her on the advisory council. She was nominated for the Spirit of Service Award by Family Elder Care, who I was talking about a little earlier with our fan drive. There are three things that you should know about Nola Marie. One, you will be struck by her grace and humility. Two, she lives to serve our community. And three, you will wonder in awe how she's able to do so much with her time. Nola once said that volunteering is a blessing. I volunteer because you never know when you'll need a little kindness in return. Nola Marie lives by these words. She volunteers for multiple groups in serving diverse members of our community, always looking to make a difference. She assists with Family Elder Care's money management department, ensuring their records are in tip-top shape as an administrative volunteer. She also volunteers at their front desk. If you go in to drop off a fan, you're probably going to see her. She greets clients who come in and are there to see their case managers. Nola has a gift for making everyone feel at ease with her gentle voice and her helpful nature. The staff at Family Elder Care say that to have a volunteer who understands the importance of treating everyone with kindness and dignity is the biggest gift she can give Family Elder Care as they strive to serve some of the most vulnerable members of our community. Let's hear her story. Would you look at these screens here?
Nola Marie Dilworth joined the Coming of Age program in 2012. She has been a phenomenal volunteer. She's what I call one of our professional volunteers. She comes to us with her schedule of her activities, and she pretty much works every day from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. She works currently with four organizations, Hospice Austin, our program Coming of Age, Family Elder Care, which is the group that nominated her for the Spirit of Service Award, and then Doug's Place, that is through Hospice Austin.
Well, Nola's been volunteering for about 3 years, and she has shared almost 3,000 hours just with us. And I know she volunteers with a couple other organizations, so I'm in awe of how much time that she shares with our community. How she impacts Family Elder Care, or how she volunteers with Family Elder Care. She's an administrative volunteer with our money management program, helping keep our records in tip-top shape for when we're audited. And most importantly, she is a greeter. She answers phones in our front lobby and is an assistant. When someone comes in the door, she's the first person they see. So those are the three main ways that she volunteers with Family Elder Care.
It's influenced my life and the fact that I see myself as paying it forward, you know, because there may be a time when I may need assistance, and, you know, it's just great, that area of giving toward others, you know, sort of my time itself. Volunteering has helped my life in the fact that it has given me the opportunity to reach out to a lot of nonprofits. It has helped me to go back and share the news with other people, how successful and how rewarding it is to be a volunteer. You know, it's not all so much about what you have, but it's what you can share with other people. So that's been very helpful for me.
You know, Nola once told me that volunteering is a blessing because you never know when you'll need a little kindness in return. And she lives by those words every day when she volunteers with us. She interacts with a diverse members of our community, and I think many of them are struck by her gentle touch. And I know that for many, the difference between having a good day and a bad day that afternoon is because of Nola. She gave them a little kindness and they really appreciated it. And for me, that's what inspires me the most about her volunteering with Family Elder Care.
Since that special moment that sticks in my mind is when one of the clients came into the office one day. He was having a bad day. He said he was hungry, not feeling good. So I just offered him just a little small peppermint. And that just cheered him up. He just smiled, you know, he just grinned. Oh, you know, have something to eat, you know, it makes me feel good. So just kindness goes a long way. You know, if I had not done that day, if I didn't offer anything to him, you know, he may have come back the next time, you know, not very friendly with me, but you know, that special day did something for him as well as for me. Kindness is free, it goes a long way.
Nola Marie, we thank you for your selfless service to our community, and we honor you today with this very prestigious 2019 Spirit of Service Award. Esther Lita Doolin, come on up here, you're next. Esther Lita, another of our 2019 Spirit of Service Award recipients. Esther Lita has been a dedicated volunteer with Foundation Communities since 2015, serving first with their Adult English as a Second Language program and then becoming an advocate for the organization. Since becoming a volunteer teaching assistant with their adult ESL classes 4 years ago, Esther Lita has served over 340 hours of service with this program alone, including 72 hours in 2018. She has touched the lives of hundreds of students. Learning basic English is essential, of course, to the success of the Foundation Communities residents. And without this skill, many of them find it very difficult to get a job, pay their bills, or even figure out the bus schedule. The ESL teachers strongly rely on volunteers to assist them during class and help them with one-on-one tutoring for adults who need a little extra support with their language skills. Esther Lita treats all of the students with great respect, insisting on learning names anytime a new student comes into the classroom.
She is admired for her command of a classroom, her self-sufficiency, and the joyful energy she brings to every interaction. As an ESL volunteer, Esther Lita has directly affected the lives of students, helping them build not just self-sufficiency, but also a community. As a community advocate, Esther Lita has worked to engage others in supporting the mission of Foundation Communities as volunteers and as donors. Foundation Communities says they are fortunate to have a caring and committed as a volunteer as Esther Lita is. Watch the video.
Esther Lita Doolin is an amazing volunteer for Foundation Communities. She has served with our ESL program for about 4 years. She joined us in 2015, and she's been a really regular and committed volunteer, coming every Thursday night to our Vintage Creek English as a Second Language class. She works directly with students, supporting our ESL instructor.
My favorite part about volunteering these days is the immediate reaction that I get from the students that come to our class. I mean, they work so hard and they're so committed, and just the little bit of assistance that I provide, they're just so appreciative, and you feel it right away, you see it right away. So I really, volunteering each week is really good for my soul. So I look forward to it. So that's my favorite part.
Not comfortable. Esther Lita in particular really embodies that idea of community. She brings so much joy and effervescence to anything that she does. So she's always really fun to have in the classroom. She also really values each and every student as an individual. She works to make sure that when there's a new student in the classroom, she learns their name, she learns how to say their name, and really works to be sure to welcome them back when they join for class again.
Volunteering allows me to actually utilize skills that I have to assist others without the responsibility of performing for an employer. That sounds so technical, but it's really, really important to me because I work hard at my job, and I believe what I do is of value to my employer, but being able to give back in a way that, or because I want to, as opposed to I have to, is really important, and it makes me a better person, I believe. Yeah. I believe I've helped the ESL students by giving them a reliable opportunity to practice their English. I mean, I'm here every Thursday night. And so I know that students can't always be in class when they want to, but they know that when they are able to come, that we will be here. I believe that I've helped Foundation Communities by providing a service that the organization doesn't have to pay for. I mean, we can spend money that we receive through donations and grants on other things and not have to pay for the services that the volunteers provide. The only thing I'll add is I'm so grateful to be recognized, and it was such a surprise. And I do this because it makes me feel good, and I believe that I'm helping other people, and just that general idea of helping other people makes me feel good, and so it's nice to be recognized for doing something that I think is good for the community.
Esther Lita Doolin, we congratulate you on your 2019 Spirit of Service Award. To all of our award recipients today, and especially our Spirit of Service Award recipients, we thank you for the difference you're making in our community and the impact that you are having. America has a long and proud tradition of volunteer service, and now more than ever, in Travis County, through Coming of Age and RSVP, We're renewing our commitment to helping others, and you all are as well, making those new connections that bring us all closer together as families and neighbors and communities. And again today, a huge thank you to all of the donors and sponsors who made this recognition special today, to our special guests for joining us today, to the Travis County Health and Human Services staff who helped us with registration and greeting, the vendor room, the photo booth, the artwork, to our volunteer photographers, Mary Voorhees and Jennifer Johnson, thank you. To our award winners for your service in helping honor our 47 years of service in Travis County. And to the staff, board, and advisory council for making service through our programs so special and recognizing how vital older adults are to the health of our communities. On a personal note, thank you to the staff for all of your hard work and my fellow advisory council members, but the staff, you did so much work in making this luncheon the very special event that it is, and we really appreciate you as a board for that. I'll be on the news at 4:35, 6, 9, and 10, and I could really use you watching. You all have a great day. I'll try to keep it cooler this summer, but no guarantees. See you next year.